Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. I am Yvonne Greer Batten, Vice Chair of the Peoria Civic Center Authority, and it is my great pleasure on behalf of the entire authority, led by our Chairman Matt Bartolo, the entire Civic Center staff, led by our General Manager Rick Edgar, it is our great pleasure to welcome the public back to the Peoria Civic Center after more than 500 days of being closed. It is also a great honor for us to have so many share in this celebration, including distinguished Peoria City leaders that oversee the work that we do here at the Civic Center, the folks that help keep the Civic Center in the forefront of the minds of event planners across the Midwest and our nation at large at Enjoy Peoria, our Convention and Visitors Bureau, members of the Peoria area and East Peoria Chambers of Commerce that have so many events here and encourage their members to do the same, the great sports teams that call this place home, our Peoria Rivermen and Bradley Braves, also to the folks that help do the media in this community, thank you for keeping our public informed about all the great activities that happen here, and to the general public at large that really make this place come to life. We are so very honored and happy and thrilled that we get to be back in this great building once again and entertain the community at large. As I mentioned, it's been more than 500 days since the coronavirus pandemic closed the doors here at the Peoria Civic Center. And with that, of course, come some changes. Those changes will be outlined by our general manager, Rick Edgar, as this event proceeds. But first, we want to share with you some of the remarkable and exciting entertainment events that we've got coming up at the Peoria Civic Center as early as this weekend. And for that, I turn the podium over to our distinguished mayor of Peoria, Dr. Rita Ali.
Thank you, Yvonne. I am just thrilled and excited to welcome live events back to the Peoria Civic Center. Starting with TBT, the basketball tournament, and Chicago. I congratulate Rick Edgar and his team and the Civic Center board in assembling a great lineup of shows coming this year, including AJR, Earth, Wind, and Fire, Jason Aldean, multiple comedians, the return of Broadway in Peoria, and many more. The Peoria Civic Center is vital to the recovery of downtown and the greater Peoria region. This venue is for the community, and with the community's support, the Peoria Civic Center is returning and it will be better than ever. So at this time, I'd like to introduce Dan Friel from TBT. Welcome, Dan.
I want to thank Mayor Ali for the introduction. Thank you all for being here. We're so excited at TBT to be here this weekend and to open up the Civic Center after that 500-day closure. TBT started 8 years ago in an arena a lot smaller than this, and I can tell you that we're really excited to be in a big place like this, and we hope to fill the house this weekend. TBT features professional basketball players from all around the world, a lot of names you're going to recognize, alumni teams from Illinois, Bradley, Syracuse, Marquette, who is our returning champion from last year, Murray State. We've got professionals that have played literally all around the world this past season, everywhere from Europe to Asia to every country in between, including some in the United States. TBT is an exciting, fast-paced game. These games are over before you know it, and if you don't pay attention, you're gonna miss the Elam ending. People have seen TBT around the country for the last year or so, have seen TBT implement this Elam ending, and I can't tell you how exciting it is. The only thing I can equate it to is the last round of a heavyweight boxing match where the two guys are just going at each other with everything that they have. So I'd very much encourage everyone to come on out and see TBT this weekend. The games start on Saturday at 11 a.m. We'll be playing here Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and on Wednesday for our regional championship round. And hopefully we see some alumni teams that you all want to root for playing on Wednesday night. Thanks a lot.
Good afternoon. It is indeed good to be back and see people back inside this wonderful asset in downtown Peoria. Over 500 days since the last time we had attendees in here, of which we were able to tout, Rick was able to tout on the board, more than 500,000 visitors and attendees through these doors, whether that's with our Peoria Rivermen or our Bradley Basketball or the Axe and Entertainment. And it truly is feels great as someone who grew up in these halls watching Bradley Basketball. I feel like we get to all come back home. And feels good. What is good for our residents is good for visitors from the convention visitor standpoint. And now that our residents are now able to enjoy this weekend, Chicago and the basketball tournament and acts to follow, visitors will follow as well. And with that is a large domino. This is a large domino that gets the fall that leads to economic impact. This is money being spent downtown that translates into tax revenue dollars for our city, both from our residents to enjoy and visitors to come visit as well. And so with that, this domino that falls and reopens allows for businesses to then trickle back downtown. And then when other businesses are opening, that comes more jobs and more opportunities for those businesses to thrive once again in the heart of Peoria. And so with that, I look forward to the progress. I want to thank the Civic Center Authority and Rick, the general manager, and on the staff here for the diligent work throughout such a tumultuous time. And it's my pleasure to introduce my friend and colleague, Rick Edgar, to say a few words. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm going to be kind of tell you how we really feel. It's been too long. It's time to turn the machine back on. The machine turns on this Saturday with the basketball tournament in Chicago. We have so many other things coming, but we do want fans to know that we're thinking about their safety in this post-pandemic world. So some of the things that we have in place is we are going to have fewer bag checks. So we're now enforcing the bag policy. It's going to be smaller. You can bring in a clutch. You can have a diaper bag if you have a child. It's going to let people have fewer touches because we don't want to be touching your bags and going through them for items. So that's why we have the smaller items or the clear bag. We also are going to enforce our no reentry policy. We've had this policy for years, but we've always made variances. But part of that is we have to go outside of security every time, and it just creates more touch points and more opportunities to have folks come in contact with each other. So we're going to enforce that. It's kind of like going to the movie theaters. I think that's something we've been talking about because we have heard from our friends who like to have us cigarette during the show. You know, if I go to the movie theater and I want to go see the cool Marvel movie that's 2.5 hours, I don't expect to leave the building and come back in. We're just kind of following programs that have already been in place. We're just going to enforce them moving forward. More importantly, we're just excited to see our people back. This weekend is awesome. We've got a nearly sold out Chicago show, but there are a few tickets available, and we have great seats for all 7 sessions of the TBT. So while we're ready to get back, I don't want it to just be this weekend. This next year, we're going to need to greet about 500,000 people over this year to get back on our feet. And we take it very seriously that we are responsible for a lot of jobs that were lost during this pandemic. And we take that with great pride that we're going to be able to get those jobs back in the downtown area and really truly be the economic epicenter. One other thing we kind of wanted to talk about, while this weekend is important, we also kind of wanted to introduce a little friend that we're going to start having pop up in the building. So many of you know we've had the Broadway series for many, many years. So we're really excited. Everyone has asked us for Hamilton. Hamilton, Hamilton, Hamilton. Part of the issue is they're going to be back in Chicago, so we can't have that show. So we tried to do it one better. Angelica Schuyler, the original Angelica Schuyler, Renee Elise Goldsberry, will be here November 5th to kick off our new Broadway series. So our new little mascot here is going to be popping around the building for the next few months. So we ask people to check her out, find her. There's going to be contests built around her. And ultimately, we hope to have a sold-out night when we kick off our Broadway series because we're really excited about what we have. And with that, I'm happy to answer any questions. And everyone have a great day, and thank you for coming out. Well, before the pandemic, we had over 500 people on our direct roster, and again, I think we can talk to our friends. We have our friends from the Marriott and the sports teams that are here. A lot of other people were employed directly related to that. So it's going to be a slow ramp up, and like a lot of folks, the hospitality industry, as a general rule, has been hit hard. So we're going to start building slowly, and hopefully we can get back to full capacities. Probably it's going to be early 22, but in the meantime, we're going to have a lot of great events to get us geared up for that.
Along similar lines, getting ramped up, before the pandemic, the Civic Center was off to a great start last year. What's it going to take to get back to those pre-pandemic trend that you had started for 2020?
We've already announced we have 20 events in October already on the books. We've announced Jason Aldean. I can't tell you how excited I am about AJR. It's the first show that my teenage daughter said, finally, Dad, you brought somebody cool to town. So in the Broadway series, so the events are coming. So part of it is getting the fans back in, and once they start seeing the attendance. But I think Peoria became a must-play stop prior to the pandemic, and we are definitely going to be back to a must-play stop after. It's the things that we can't talk about today, we're excited about, but we have to have fans come out to shows, and when they see those numbers, I feel very comfortable that those shows are coming back.
And with that, bringing larger crowds, though, back together as the pandemic still starts to, with the Delta variant starting to become more of a problem, what concerns are still around having large crowds like this?
Well, I think it's the same concerns that we have in society today. You know, we hear about the Delta variant. We're very much aware of it. We're asking citizens to be nice, be kind to our staff, be kind to your neighbors. If you haven't been vaccinated, please wear a mask. It's not your personal choice to come and get yourself sick at our events and hurt other people. You know, and I think that's one thing that we really wanted to go through today. We've been talking to our staff. It's been so long. We're all excited to see everybody, but we want people to be kind to each other. I think that's something that's been lost, and maybe it's a more worldly statement. But we want folks to be nice. I mean, we haven't done this for over 500 days. I mean, we're not exaggerating. And you know what? Sometimes those transactions that used to happen like that are going to take a few minutes. So it may take you a couple minutes to get a hot dog, but just kind of remember, these folks miss you too, and just be kind of nice to your neighbor. That's really the biggest message I could get out of today, is just be nice. Did I do okay? Any of you other gentlemen have questions? Awesome. Well,
I have one more follow-up.
Absolutely.
You kind of mentioned getting a hot dog and all that in concessions. What kind of precautions are being done around the eating? I mean, with condiments, anything like that, as far as, you know, contact or anything?
That's actually a great question. You're going to see more single serve, so the big pumps of ketchup and things that you used to get before, you're now going to have individual packets so that you're touching your items, and some of the items will be prepackaged when we serve. So we're going to, the biggest code word right now is reduce touch points, constant sanitation. So we're going to take a lot of little steps, and we're not going to do everything right, but we're going to try. And I think as we go through this weekend and as we progress, we'll probably see more of those type items coming forward.
I've actually got one.
Absolutely.
So right now at this time, we have a lot of people that are very heavy, one side very heavy on the other side of whether they want to go out, whether they want to stay in. What would you say to those people that are on the border that aren't quite sure whether or not they should go out or want to go out or just nervous and trying to get back into the community doing these events?
That's an excellent question. I think it's a personal choice, and we're going to make the environment as welcoming as we possibly can. So I can tell you that we, all of our staff, everyone has been vaccinated, and if they're not vaccinated, they will absolutely be wearing a mask for protection. But I would tell you the vast majority of our staff has been vaccinated. And we think, you know, we have people coming to these events. We want them to come and be safe. So I think the number one key is, I think you're hearing constantly, is get vaccinated if you at all can, you know. But I also understand we have like shows like Blippi that are a kids show. We're going to really request those parents, you know, protect your child, have them wear a mask, because that show is targeted at younger children, four years old. We know that they can't be vaccinated, but we are leaving that to the parents to make that decision. But also be responsible to the person next to you. So again, we're kind of going back to that theory of be nice to your neighbors, do unto others, and I think we'll have a much better opening.
Thank you.
Awesome. It's been great. Please take plenty of pictures. It's going to be a lot more people here, so it's one of the rare times you get to see the court open. So thanks for your time.